Psalm 18, verse 17, the Bible says, "He delivered me from my strong enemy and from them which hated me. For they were too strong for me." Now, this morning, or today, this evening, afternoon, night, wherever you are, whatever time zone, I need us to come to terms with reality. There are enemies that are considered strong enemies. These are enemies you've been battling with for years, and it appears that the mountains are insurmountable. The more you pray, the more they attack. The Bible considers them strong enemies. Strong enemies. These are enemies that see your life as their project. They are personalized enemies. That's what the Bible called them. "He delivered me from my," it didn't say the strong enemies, "my strong enemies." So there are enemies in our lives that are so strong. In other words, they are more connected, they are more resilient. Even when you are almost sick and tired of being sick and tired, they are still pressing on. He said, "He delivered me from my strong enemies. From them which hated me, they were too strong for me." They are connected. Look at a man like Haman in the book of Esther. Haman was a strong enemy. Haman was ruthless, was brutal, was lethal. Emma was that enemy that would go any length. He invested to see that a whole race was wiped out. He invested to see that a whole race was exterminated. Emma was a strong enemy. Strong enemies are those who are connected, those who are resilient, those who are restless, those who are determined to see your extinction. But my God will deliver you from them.
Amen.
My God will deliver you from them.
Amen.
My God will deliver you from them.
Amen.
Strong enemies are loud enemies. It's known to people that these people don't like you. Look at the brothers of Joseph. Those were also considered strong enemies. We call them brothers, but Joseph didn't call them brothers. No. In 1 Samuel 16, 13, the Bible says, "And Samuel took the vow of oil, anointed David in the midst of his brethren, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon him from that day forward." That's what Samuel did. But for David, he never called them his brothers. In Psalm 23, verse 5, he said, "Thou anointest me with oil, anointest my head with oil in the presence of my enemies." 1 Samuel 16, 13 said, "In the midst of his brethren." But while David was giving his account in Psalm 23, verse 5, he said, "In the presence of my enemies." These are not my brothers. They are my enemies. We're going to take that prayer loud and clear. Oh Lord, deliver me from my strong enemy.
Amen.
Oh Lord, deliver me from my strong enemy.
Amen.
Oh Lord, deliver me from my strong enemy.
Amen.
These are people who are more connected, more experienced, even more advanced in the act of combat than you. At that point, you need an intervention from God to rescue you out of their hands. Oh Lord, deliver me from my strong enemies.
Amen.
Say, "My Father, my Father."
My father.
Shout it loud and clear.
My father.
Let the enemies hear your voice.
My father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh Lord. Deliver me from my strong enemy. Deliver me from my strong enemy. Open your mouth and fire prayer.
Asha karo Thank you. Ya ta 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 Verdade, 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 ver Rakata 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 rak
In Jesus' name.